The way this all happens is that I'm using software called mimoLive, which is like having a television control room on your computer or your laptop. It's Mac native. It just works on Mac. But we've been using it since the end of, well, I've been using it since the end of May 2020, so that we can have these nice graphics and things like this show up. And have the split screens and multiple calls, and it allows us to me to have multiple microphones, image sources, stills, and all sorts of wonderful things like that. So let's see, I will show you first. Here is the button. I think this is the correct.
This is the big control.
All right, so one thing you should know, Mon, if you just pan this way a little bit, you'll see. So over to my right, yeah. So right here, I have an iPad on an iPad stand, and right here is my MacBook Pro. And the reason you see a blue glow is that I have a cool pad with fans, like a gamer has, blowing air on it. And one of the things I learned from the folks who use mimoLive from the mimoLive forum is that you can't really see it, but we have an ice pack under the laptop.
Very high tech.
Very high tech, but boy, you know, every once in a while it'll look like the video playback is locking up on the films, and it's caused by something called thermal throttling, and putting an ice pack on the bottom of your laptop clears that right up. So that's what...
Steve's mic is still on.
Oh, yeah, I'll take Steve's mic off for a second. So, Mona, so you can tilt back up now.
Okay.
So that's what... so that's the devices I have. So on my right over here, I will show you... This is what I'm looking at on my right. Oop, here it is. So don't worry, we haven't frozen. That's a still image. But that's what I'm looking at. And the four columns you see on the far left column are all the input sources, all the graphics, remote calls, audio sources, and like that. And the second one are a series of layers. They're called layers, but all the different graphic elements and the way things are woven together. Then there's a preview. And other settings for the different, they're called layers that I click on. In the far right, you see a preview window where I see the image of the actual feed. And if your head's spinning, you think about me, I'm playing the piano and also watching this.
Well, you're it's, good at it.
Yeah, being a theater organist, I think, helped me because you're multitasking.
Yeah.
So between me and the laptop is the iPad, which functions as a remote control surface that I can customize. And that looks like this. For this show, anyway, and the red, this is a screen grab that I got. So the red indicates what is live or is not live, and these are different buttons that I've assigned to different functions. And what you'll see, so when I lean over and appear to tap something, it triggers something to turn on or off. And one of the things that you see the green buttons at the bottom, those start the films. Now, what I can tell you. Is there's a bit of magic that happens when I hit that button because a number of things have to happen for the film to start. Number one is it switches my microphone. So I've got a lavalier right here. But Mon, if you pan right just a little bit.
Sure, the piano.
Yeah. I have a separate microphone there. You can kind of see it's the little red glow right here. It's my Zoom. It's a stereo mic. You can pan back, and so it's that orange toggle button. Tells the mimoLive software, okay, switch Ben's mic from the lavalier to the piano mic. It does something else. It also launches an automation script, which looks like, I think this is the right button, it looks like this. And even I don't quite understand it, but it's a little crazy. But what the automation script does is it makes all those things happen. It also starts a timer that lasts, we figured out it takes 12 seconds for me to play you into the film and for Mona to pan up into the screen. And after 12 seconds, the software automatically dissolves from the projected image, we have a video projector on the wall, into a direct feed of the file straight out to you. And when the film ends, it dissolves back to the wall.
And it's all in sync.
It's all completely in
sync.
Yeah, and that script was created, I had written to Oliver and Achim Breidenbach, who are the two gentleman who created this software many years ago, and I'm in touch with them, and I participate in the users forum. And I told them what I was trying to do Because originally I had two laptops and I was turning things on and off, and they thought, that sounds very interesting, and they had a solution. They Zoomed with me at the end of 2020, and we created this automation script. So that's how I fly the plane, and that's
like Captain Kirk.
Yeah, and that's when it's working.
Enterprise.
And sometimes I'll cut to something, and I'll be copying files over and finding new workarounds while it's happening. I'm playing, and I'm going to glance over and just make sure everything's okay. Basically, that's how the sausage gets made. So I'm looking at my show rundown. So the next thing we're going to do is Steve, here to tell you a little bit more about our next film. Here's Steve. Hi, Steve.
Hello.
Hey.
All right.
All I can say after all that is yikes.
Yeah.
stuff.
Yeah.
It's like, wow, it's pretty
yes.
amazing.